Ladies and gentlemen, after I did 2112 in Tom Sawyer, and then I did the animated 2112, and that was blocked. I posted a link for everybody in the community post, so I hope you guys got an opportunity to see that. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. That would really mean a lot. But the next song that you told me to look into after the fact was Rush, Xanadu, Exit Stage Left from 1981. And I'm not going to talk you to death. This is a 12-minute and 16-second masterpiece, I'm sure. But this is the first time I'm hearing. But after what I heard from 2112, I have no doubt in my mind that this is a masterpiece. I have already set my whole mindset for it. I'm talking too much. Rush, I need to hear you now. Let's go. They set me up for something. I can feel it. They set me up for something. Neil was over there with his whole drum set looking like a house, looking like an apartment he just moving into. Listen, I'll be here for the duration, okay? You go ahead and play. I'll be here for the duration. Let's go back. want that synthesizer or that. Isn't that a Moog? I think it's a Moog keyboard. Whichever the case is, I want that. These guys are amazing. They're bouncing in and out of time signature. Wow. It only took 3 men to do all this? That's what you can do when you are dedicated to your craft. Clearly, I could see now why they are considered one of the greatest bands that's ever done it. I've talked about Neil a lot because for the longest time, I mean, that's the only thing I knew about Rush. But as I go down this rabbit hole, I'm going to get to know both the other two members as well. And then I see all of these drum solos that I haven't witnessed yet. But that's going to have to be done as well. Because when you go down a rabbit hole, you got to find as many rabbits as you can. And I got an armload of carrots. Till next time, this is Drumside. Thanks for watching.